Hello friends, today we are going to discuss some MCQs on organisms and populations. So if you want to try to solve these questions yourself, then please mute the video and solve this one by one. So let's start. Question number one. Refer the given flowchart. Individuals to populations to X. Identify X and select the correct option. And here the correct option is option A, communities. A natural association of interdependent populations of different species inhabiting a common environment or habitat as a viable self-contained unit is called a biotic community or biokinesis. Next, in the given figure, identify the temperate forest and coniferous forest respectively from the marking A to F and select the correct option. And the correct option is option C. Coniferous forest occur just south of tundra across North America, Europe, Asia, and are also found in southern hemisphere. Precipitation in coniferous forests is 10 to 35 centimeter in drier parts and over 150 centimeter in wetter parts. It occurs both as rain as well as snow. The average temperature is less than 15 degrees Celsius. Temperate forests are found in both northern and southern hemispheres. Their annual precipitation lies between 75 to 250 centimeter, and average temperature lies between 6 to 20 degrees Celsius. Next, which of the following options is correct? On the left hand side, stenothermal organism, and on the right hand side, urethermal organism. And here the correct option is option B. Organisms with narrow range of temperature tolerance are called stenothermal organisms. Example, polar bear, frog, lizards, coconut, etc. The organisms with wide range of temperature tolerance are called urethermal organisms. Example, most mammals and birds. Next, a place has very scanty rainfall. The dominant plants there may be A. Opuntia, B. Nymphaea, C. Asparagus, D. both A and C. And the correct option is option D. The plants which grow in dry or xeric conditions or where availability of water is negligible are known as xerophytes. Opuntia and asparagus are succulents which store water in their stem and root respectively. Next, organisms that can tolerate a wide range of salt concentration are termed as, and the correct answer is option C, eudihaline. Eudihaline organisms are able to tolerate a wide range of salt concentration or salinities. Example, Poecilia spinops is a fish that can live in a fresh water, brackish water or salt water. Next, which of the following algae are found in deepest ocean waters? A. Red algae, B. Yellow algae, C. Green algae and D. Brown algae. And the correct option is option A. The red color of red algae is due to abundant formation of phycoerythrin, which is able to absorb blue-green wavelengths of light. Being shorter, these wavelengths are able to reach the maximum depth in water. Therefore, red algae can be found in deepest ocean water. Next, read the following statements and select the correct ones. 1. All color components of the visible spectrum are available for marine plants living in different depths of ocean. 2. Many herbs and shrubs in rainforest adapt to photosynthesize optimally under very low light conditions as they grow under canopy trees. 3. Gradual increase in average global temperature will affect the distributional range of some species. And 4. The quality of soil doesn't depend upon the weathering process. And the correct option is option C, both 2 and 3. In deep water bodies such as lakes and oceans, there occurs light zonation, Light zones are categorized as littoral zone, limnetic zone, profundal zone, and benthic zone. Due to this, not all color components of the visible spectrum are available to marine plants. Also, some components like red have very poor penetration. In tropical rainforests, the vegetation shows stratification, which is the grouping of plants in a forest into two or more well-defined layers depending upon their height, like tall trees, medium-sized trees, small trees, bushes, herbs, etc. The shrubs and herbs adapt to stratification and photosynthesize optimally under low-light conditions. Temperature governs physiological function and geographical distribution of many plants and animals. Any change in temperature will affect their distribution. Weathering or breaking of rocks into fine powder can occur due to atmospheric changes, mechanical forces or mechanical weathering, chemical changes or chemical weathering, and biological breakdown or biological weathering. It affects the quality of soil. Next, organisms that can maintain a constant internal temperature are called as, and the correct answer is option A. Animals with constant body temperature are called homeotherms. They have insulating coat to check the loss of body heat. The coat consists of hair in most mammals, blubber, subcutaneous fat in whales and seals, and feathers in birds. Shivering warms up the body and perspiration cools down the body of these animals when required. These are also termed endotherms, as they regulate their body temperature by physiological means and maintain more or less constant internal temperature. Poikilotherms are cold-blooded animals which are unable to regulate their body temperature with change in temperature of environment. Example, fish, frog, lizards. They are also called as ectotherms. They are also called ectotherms. Next, the given graph represents how three different living organisms X, Y, and Z cope with the external environmental conditions. Study the graph and select the correct option regarding X, Y, and Z. A. X could be a mammal. B. Y could be a bird. C. Z could be a mammal. D. X could be a bird. And the correct answer is option B. Y could be a bird. X conformers. These are the animals and plants in which the osmotic concentration and temperature of body changes according to ambient conditions of external environment. Example, asterias. Y, regulators. These are able to maintain a constant body temperature and constant osmotic concentration despite changes in external environment. Example, birds and mammals. Z, partial regulators. They have the ability to regulate body functions to a limited extent, beyond which they become conformers. Next, an animal that can survive at 10 degrees Celsius and 40 degrees Celsius both can be placed under the category of, and the correct answer is option B, regulators. Next, when organisms change their location to escape from harsh environment, it is called as, and the answer is option C, migration. The seasonal movement of complete population of animals to a more favorable environment is called migration. It is usually in response to uneven precipitation and lower temperatures, resulting in a reduced food supply, and is often triggered by a change in day length. Migration is common in mammals, example, porpoises, fish, example, eels and salmon, and some insects, but is most marked in birds. Next, which of the following options exemplifies a behavioral means of homeostasis? And here the correct answer is option D. Both A, B and C. A man sweating profusely in hot room, and B, a rhino covering itself in mud to keep cool. The reason? Some organisms show behavioral adaptation to cope with variations in their environment. A rhino covering itself in mud to keep cool and desert lizard basking in sun to keep warm are examples of behavioral means of homeostasis. Desert lizards lack the physiological ability to deal with the high temperature, so they keep their body temperature fairly constant by behavioral means. They enjoy in the sun and absorb heat when their body temperature drops below the comfort zone, but move into shade when the surrounding temperature starts increasing. Some species are capable of burrowing into the soil to hide and escape from too much heat. Next, very small animals are rarely found in polar regions because A, small animals have a large surface area relative to their volume, so they lose body heat very fast when it is cold outside. B, small animals have a smaller surface area relative to their volume, so they lose body heat very fast when it is cold outside. C, small body volumes makes internal heat production very difficult. D, none of this. And the correct answer is option A. Temperature affects the absolute size of an animal and the relative proportion of various body parts. Birds and mammals attain greater body size in cold regions than in warm areas, but poikilotherms are smaller in cold region. This is Bargmann's rule. This is true because small animals have little volume but larger surface area. So if they are in cold, they lose their body heat very fast. In cold climate, reduced surface area to volume ratio is ideal. Next, kangaroo and desert rat that live in conditions of water scarcity are capable of meeting all their water equipments or water requirements by A, having thick coat to minimize evaporative desiccation, B, oxidizing stored fat to produce water as byproduct, C, producing very concentrated urine and solid feces, D, all of this. And the correct answer is option D, all of this. Kangaroo and desert rat seldom drink water. It has a thick coat to minimize evaporative desiccation. The animal seldom comes out of its comparatively humid and cool burrow during the daytime. 90% of its water requirement is met from metabolic water, which is produced by respiratory breakdown of fats. 10% is obtained from food. Loss of water is minimized by producing nearly solid urine and feces. Next, which of the following statements is incorrect? And here the incorrect statement is option A. Osmoconformers are able to maintain osmotic concentration of their cells by their physiological or behavioral means. Actually, osmoconformers are the organisms that change the osmotic concentration of their body with the changing ambient conditions. Their body fluids are in osmotic balance with the environment. For many marine invertebrates, the osmolarity and ionic concentrations of their body fluids are similar to those of the seawater in which they live. Next, which of the following is an incorrect match? And the correct option is option D. Aestivation is a state of inactivity occurring in some animals, notably lungfish, during prolonged periods of drought or heat. Feeding, respiration, movement, and other bodily activities are considerably slowed down. Reptiles such as lizards hibernate in winters. Next, read the following statements about adaptation in desert plants and select the correct ones. 1. They have a thick cuticle on their leaf surfaces. 2. They have stomata present in deep sunken pits. 3. They use CAM pathway for photosynthesis. 4. They have flattened stems and large sized leaves. And 5. Their stomata remain closed during the day. And here the correct answer is option D. Xerophytes can withstand a prolonged period of drought. For this purpose, they have certain peculiar adaptations. Thick cuticle is present in these plants. Stomata are generally sunken or deep-seated and open during night only. They have camp pathway for photosynthesis. Leaves are generally small and scaly. Sometimes leaves are modified into spines to reduce water loss through transpiration. They generally have an extensive root system and a smaller shoot system. Stems may be modified to phylloclades or cladodes to carry out the function of photosynthesis. Next, an inhabitant of Varanasi goes to Rohtang and experiences nausea, fatigue, and heart palpitations. It is because A. he is experiencing altitude sickness. B. his RBC count is lower than required. C. he is in an area of low atmospheric pressure. D. all of these. And the answer is D. all of these. When we go to high altitude places, that is greater than 3500 meters, we experience altitude sickness. Its symptoms include nausea, fatigue, and heart palpitations. It is due to the low atmospheric pressure of high altitudes that the body doesn't get enough oxygen. The body compensates low oxygen availability by increasing RBC production, decreasing the binding capacity of hemoglobin, and by increasing breathing rate. Next, Dash rule states that mammals from colder climates generally have shorter ears and limb to minimize heat loss. A. Allens, B. Burgers, C. Borges, and D. Powells. And the correct answer is option A. According to Allen's rule, in endothermal animals of colder areas, the extremities like feet, tail, ears, etc. tend to be smaller as compared to their relatives in warmer regions. This minimizes heat loss. Next, whales can resist tissue compression during diving because they have A. special proteins that prevent air absorption, B. extensive blood vascular culture which swells up to reduce the size of air-filled cavities, C. thick coat of fat around body that works as an insulator, D. none of this. And the answer is option B. Whales can resist tissue compression. Their air sinuses in head have an extensive vasculature which facilitates equilibration of air pressure within these spaces. Also, the middle ear cavity becomes engorged at depth to reduce the air space and prevent tissue distortion. Next, read the following statements regarding adaptations in deep diving sea creatures such as sperm whales and bottlenose whales and select the correct ones. 1. They have collapsible lungs which reduce lung rupture and increase blood nitrogen level. 2. During the dive, they rely on oxygen stored in their blood and muscles. 3. Air-filled sinuses have extensive blood vessels that swell up during diving to reduce the size of air-filled spaces. 4. Hemoglobin concentration in this mammal is twice as much as that found in terrestrial mammals. 5. Concentration of myoglobin, oxygen storage pigment, is extremely elevated in these animals. And here the correct answer is option D, all of these. Deep diving sea creatures such as sperm whales and bottlenose whales have collapsible lungs which forces airway from the alveoli. This blunting of gas exchange prevents absorption of nitrogen into blood and reduces blood nitrogen level. They rely on large oxygen stores in their blood and muscles. Deep sea divers have an extensive vasculature which reduces size of air-filled cavities. The concentration of hemoglobin and myoglobin are elevated in deep sea divers. Next, assuming that an animal generates heat at a rate proportional to its volume and can radiate heat at a rate proportional to its body surface area, which of the following would be best at maintaining its body temperature in cold climate? And the answer is option C, beer. In a beer, the surface area is less as compared to volume. Thus, it will generate more heat and radiate less, making it suitable for living in cold climate. Next, dart frogs found in tropical rainforests of South America are highly poisonous as well as brightly colored to be easily noticed. This is referred to as. The correct answer is option C, warning coloration. Dart frogs exhibit warning coloration. Predators usually avoid them because they are highly poisonous. Next, given graph represents the response of organisms to various abiotic factors. On this basis, select the correct option for 1, 2 and 3. And here is the correct answer is option D. Next, given figure represents the different zones of a lake or a pond. Identify the labeled parts X, Y and Z and select the correct statement. And here, the correct statement is option A. X constitutes the shallow water banks and is called as littoral zone. On the other hand, Y is the photic zone. Limnetic zone is open water zone up to the depth to which light can penetrate. Z, profundal zone, it is deep water zone where the light does not penetrate. Next, the population growth is generally described by the following equation: dN dt equal rn k minus n by k. What does r represents in the given equation? And the answer is option B, intrinsic rate of natural increase. A population growing in a habitat with limited resources show a sigmoid growth curve. This type of population growth is called Verhulst-Perl logistic growth as given by the equation dN dt rn k minus n by k, where n is the population density at time t, r equal intrinsic rate of natural increase and k is the carrying capacity. Next, which type of interaction is represented by the given figure? A, mutualism, B, parasitism, C, heliotism, D, amensalism. And the correct answer is option A. Mutualism is an association between individuals of two species, both of which are benefited. The species participating in mutualism are called mutualists. Sea anemone Adamsia is habitually found first in by its characteristically lobed pedal disc to the snail's shell used as a portable home by the hermit crab. And the scientific name of hermit crab is Eupagorus predoxi. The anemone protects the crab from enemies with its nematocysts. In return, anemone receives pieces of food dropped by the crab and is carried to new places by it. Other examples of mutualism are mycorrhiza living on roots of higher plants and wasp pollinating fig inflorescences. Next, species interaction with negative influence on both is referred to as. Here the correct answer is option D, competition. Competition is defined as the active demand by two or more individuals of same species or members of two or more species at same trophic levels for a common resource. Intraspecific competition is competition amongst members of the same species for a common resource such as for food, space and mate. Interspecific competition is rivalry amongst members of different species. The severity of competition depends upon the similarity in requirement of food and shelter. Next, in some cases, population density is measured in terms of biomass rather than in terms of numbers because A. It is a more meaningful measure when considered organisms vary greatly in size. It is more convenient when population is huge and counting is impossible or very time consuming. See, it is a relatively constant measure, and D, both A and B. And the correct answer is option D, both A and B. Although the total number is most appropriate measure of population density, but in some cases it is difficult to determine. In a forest area, suppose there are 200 Parthenium plants, but only a single huge banyan tree with large canopy. Stating that the population density of banyan is low relative to that of Parthenium amounts to understanding the great role of the banyan in that forest community. In such cases, the percent cover or biomass is a more meaningful measure of the population size. If the population is huge and counting is impossible for very time consuming, the total number is not easily measured. Example, for a dense laboratory culture of bacteria in a petri dish, only the biomass can be used as a measure of its density. Next, the maximum possible numbers of individuals that a habitat can support is called its. And here the correct answer is option C, carrying capacity. In nature, a given habitat has resources to support a certain number of individuals of a population beyond which no further growth is possible. This limit is called as nature's carrying capacity, K, for the species in that habitat. Next, which of the following equations correctly represents Verhulst for logistic growth? And here we know, all know the answer. The answer is option A. Next, which of the following equations correctly represents the exponential population growth curve? And here the correct answer is option D, both A and C. Next, study the population growth curves A and B in the given graph and select the incorrect option. And here the incorrect option is option C. Exponential growth curve is considered as more realistic than logistic growth curve. Since resources of growth for most animal populations become limiting sooner or later, the logistic growth model is more realistic. Next, which of the following statements is correct? Geometric growth produces J-shaped population growth curve. B, logistic growth occurs when resources are limiting. C, equation for exponential growth is nt equal n0 e to the power rt. And D, all of these. And the correct answer is option D, all of these. Next, when two similar species live in the same area, they may evolve to become more different in order to A, drive the other species to extinction. B, reduce competition. C, use up the other species resources. D, reduce genetic variation. And the correct answer is option B. According to the mechanism of resource partitioning supported by MacArthur, if two species compete for the same resource, they could avoid competition by choosing, for instance, different times for feeding or different foraging patterns. Two species evolve to become different to reduce competition so that both species can do coexist. Next, human cells contain mitochondria, which are responsible for producing the energy needed by our cells. Remember that the ancestors of mitochondria may once have been free living prokaryotes. If mitochondria were still considered to be separate organisms within our cells, which of the following would best describe our relationship with them? And the correct answer is option B. If mitochondria are still considered to be separate organisms, they would form mutualistic relationship with us. This is because they would get the resources from us and in turn produce energy for various activities of the body. Next, cowbirds lay their eggs in the nests of smaller birds. The first developing cowbird chicks hatch first, then push the other baby chicks out of the nest as they hatch. The cowbird is classified as a pathogen, B, parasite, C, mutualist, D, commensal. The correct answer is option B, parasite. Brood parasitism in birds is an example of parasitism in which the parasitic bird lays its eggs in the nest of its host, and the host incubates them. This way, the bird can save the energy that it would have spent in incubation and can use that energy in foraging and other activities. During this course of evolution, the eggs of the parasite birds have evolved to resemble the host's eggs in size and color to reduce the chances of the host bird detecting the foreign eggs and removing them from the nest. Laying eggs by cuckoo or quail in crow's nest is brood parasitism. Cowbirds are also show brood parasitism. Next, the prickly pear cactus became unusually abundant after its introduction in Australia because it, and here the correct answer option A, had no co-evolved herbivores. Coevolution is caused by the selection pressure that each of the two species exerts on the other. Since there has been no co-evolved herbivore with prickly pear cactus, it became abundant in Australia. Next, why you never see cattle or goats browsing on wheat calotropis? And here the answer is option C. The plant produces poisonous cardiac glycosides. Prey species have evolved various defenses to lessen the impact of predation. For plant, herbivores are the predators. Plants have evolved an astonishing variety of morphological and chemical defenses against herbivores. Calotropis produces highly poisonous cardiac glycosides, and that is why we never see any cattle or goat browsing on this plant. A wide variety of chemical substances that we extract from plants on a commercial scale, like nicotine, caffeine, quinine, strychnine, opium, etc., are produced by them actually as defenses against grazers and browsers. Next, which of the following statements is incorrect? And here the incorrect statement is option C. No two species can occupy exactly the same niche in the same geographical area. Sorry, this is the correct answer. This is the correct answer. Two or more species with closely similar niche requirements cannot exist indefinitely in the same area, as sooner or later they come into competition for possession of it. This is called as Gauss competitive exclusion principle, which state that an ecological niche cannot be simultaneously and completely occupied by established populations of more than one species. Two species can live in same habitat but not in the same niche. More similar the two niches are, severe the competition is. Next, in laboratory experiments, two species of the protists, Paramecium species 1 and 2, were grown alone, and in the presence of the other species, the following graphs show growth of species 1 and species 2, both alone and when in mixed culture with the other species. Which of the following conclusions can be drawn from the graphs? And the correct answer is option C. Both species are affected by interspecific competition, but species 2 is affected less. When species 1 was kept with species 2, its number of individuals fell drastically, while when species 2 was kept with species 1, its total number of individuals was not much affected. Hence, both species are affected by interspecific competition, but species 2 is less affected. Next, on the rocky seacoast of Scotland, the larger and comparatively superior barnacle Balanus dominates the intertidal area and excludes the smaller barnacle Cathamalus from that zone. Which kind of interaction is being depicted by this example? A, predation; B, parasitism; C, commensalism; D, competition. And the correct answer is option D, competition. Competition keeps the population of inferior species under check. Superior barnacle nearly excluded the smaller barnacle, but if Balanus population is reduced, competition is released and Cathamella's population increases. Next, match column 1 and column 2 and select the correct option from the quotes given below. And here the correct answer is option A. Next, read the given examples of animals' interactions. 1. An orchid growing as an epiphyte on a mango branch. 2. Barnacles growing on the back of whale. 3. Clownfish living among the stinging tentacles of sea anemone. 4. Cattle egrets foraging close to the grazing cat. And the correct answer is option D. Means commensalism. When two or more similar animals live together and if there is no physiological dependence between them, they are referred to as commensals. And the relationship between such organisms is called commensalism. In commensalism, one animal might get the benefit from the association while the other is neither benefited nor harmed. The advantages derived by commensals involve the provision of substratum, shelter, transport and food. And the last question. Niche overlaps indicates a mutualism between two species, B, active cooperation between two species, 3, two different parasites on the same host, and D, sharing of one or more resources between the two species. And the correct answer is option D, sharing of one or more resources between the two species. Ecological niche means the total interaction of a species with its environment or its functional position or status in an ecosystem. Ecological niche depends on the species' structural adaptations, physical responses, and behavior. Niche overlap means that one or more resources are shared between two species. There are more MCQs from this chapter, and I will upload others in my next video. I hope that you guys got your answers and understand these questions very well. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.